So I'm sitting in the same spot that I filmed in my last video, except I'm freezing cold and it's October. Things have been kind of crazy, and I really can't complain too much. During the summer, I started an exercise program that really helped me, and I was feeling better than I felt in years. Hi everyone, right now I'm with my mom, there she is, and we are headed to the gym. This is our second day. Yes, it's early morning. 10 o'clock, which is like a record for us because we are not morning people, and hopefully by the end of the week we're not both dead. I'm hoping that my heart rate doesn't go up too high while I exercise and that I get through it okay. As you can see, I'm wearing a heart monitor. Right now my heart is about 94, and we'll see what it does when I get on the bike. This is actually our fourth day of exercise, and so far we're doing pretty good, so we hope we keep it up and get better and better as we keep going. I've actually been doing a lot better. With how exhausted and weak I was, I couldn't even contemplate going to the gym and actually doing a workout. But I started incredibly slow, and it's something that I'm not only proud of, but amazed by. I feel like I've been truly blessed because I've been given a part of my life back. Am I back to where I was? No. I still get very tired and weak easily, but I have definitely seen a lot of improvement, and it's been incredible. It's been more than I ever could have asked for. I consider it a miracle, really. I was almost feeling like my old self. I was working really hard on getting back to my life. Obviously, when you're dealing with a chronic illness, your life isn't usually what you want it to be. Wow, my life was so empty. Here I was feeling good, and looking at my life, it was like I had nothing to do and nowhere to be. Because I've been so sick, thinking about things that I wanted to do that I couldn't do was really depressing for me. So I took time out. I asked myself, what are my dreams? And I thought, you know what? I'm tired of pretending I don't have dreams. Just because I'm sick doesn't mean that my dreams have vanished. They're still there. They just seem a little further to reach. If I could do anything, if my choices were limitless, or if I didn't have to worry about whether or not I'll be sick tomorrow or how I'll feel, what would make me the happiest? It was honestly one of the most fun things that I've done in a long time. I felt so happy. I was like sitting there writing and thinking like, wow, you know, maybe these things are possible. And it was just such a wonderful thing just to allow myself to dream again. One of the biggest things that I came up with was that I wanted to help people. I feel like I've been given POTS to do something with it, to have the empathy that I have and the compassion. I've met a lot of people who've been treated terribly, and it's done something to me. It's kind of lit a spark inside of me, and it's made me want to help people, and it's made me want to do something about it. And I decided that I would like to have my own office where I could help people. I feel like I've learned so much, not just about POTS, but about a lot of illnesses and conditions because of all the research I had to do when I was trying to figure out my own. And I think it's something I would be good at. So the more I thought about it, I thought, you know what, if I'm gonna do that, I would like to be a doctor of natural medicine. Even though my medications were a godsend at the time, I realize now that there are a lot of natural things that you can do to help yourself. So what I did was, and keep in mind that during this week I was feeling pretty good, I was working out, I was very active, I reapplied to the old college that I applied to 3 years ago prior to my illness. And the whole time I'm thinking like, I'm never gonna be able to do this, I don't know, you know, if this is even possible. You know, some days I can't even get out of bed, how would I make it to class? I put all of it aside and I applied. Thought worst comes to worst, I'll lose like the $75 application fee. And I met with a counselor and I talked to him about making accommodations for me, and so far I'm planning to attend in January. So when I think about like going for pre-med, I feel like, am I crazy? But it's a dream I have, it's something I'm really passionate about, and I'm gonna try. If I can, I can't, but I feel like I was given such a wonderful gift when I started to feel good because it allowed me to dream again. And I realized what life was like walking around dreamlessly. I figure if I could just try to do this, and if somehow I manage it, it would be wonderful.
I can't remember the last time that we kissed goodbye. All our I love yous were just not enough to survive.
I'd have a little office where people could come in and I would give them my full attention.
Me, but it's only now too plain to see. Brilliant disguise when you hold me and I'm free. I've been thinking and here's what I've come to conclude. Sometimes the distance is more.
I was working really hard on getting back to my life, and sorry about that, somebody just started waving at me because I'm holding a camera. I think they thought that they were on tape. it was kind of strange. I thought I knew them, but I don't. So-